The South Dakota State women's basketball team is now 16-4 as they enter this week. The Jacks won a pair of games at home last week, beginning on Thursday against IUPUI, in a battle very similar to the week before against South Dakota. This time it was Aaron Johnston's squad making the big basket late. A mid-range jump shot from freshman Madison Giebert.
We're tied at 66-66. Jackrabbits need a basket to win here in double overtime. 10 seconds to go. Coach Parkinson calling his defense out. Gabby Madison-Giebert, pull-up jumper, got it, 6-2, 4.5 seconds to go.
IUPUI game was a tough one. They defend very well. They do a great job of just not giving you what you want, you know, and they take away some of the strengths of your players. I thought Macy had a tough game right there. She had a very good defensive player on her, and she just never really got going. We were fortunate at the game. I thought Kira Young played very well. She had a great weekend, but in that game, she made some big plays for us. Gabby, in her first start this year, had a big game for us as well, hit some shots, a couple key free throws, and we needed them to kind of hang in there in the fourth and in the first overtime. Then obviously Madison's big shot at the end there to finally give us a lead in that second overtime was key. Jess Miras really rebounded well, gave us really good minutes inside. So we didn't have anybody. It was just a big standout, but everybody played pretty well, and we needed it because IUPUI played very well as well.
The Jacks have now had 9 games decided by 8 points or less and come out victorious in 6 of those contests.
I feel really good about where we're at in the year. We have had a ton of close games. Every game we've played this year, we've had a chance to win. And it's rare that you get into your 20th game and you can look back and say every game we had a chance. And the majority of those, obviously, we've found a way to get it done. Often you just have a night or two where things just don't go your way. Another team gets really hot, whatever it might be. And so far this year, this team has been really consistent. I think defense has been the big reason. You know, we've never let a team just go out there and get 85 where we can't keep up with them. Our defense has been very, very consistent. And we have a lot of different players that can make plays. So we really don't rely on any one player to carry us. We have a lot of players that can make big shots when we need them to.
On Saturday, the offense got going for SDSU. The Jacks made 54% of their first half shots, including 6 three-pointers that earned a dominating 85-63 win over Western Illinois.
Yeah, the Western Illinois game was a good game for us. We just hadn't shot the ball well in a few games, and to get that many shots to go down early was important for our team. Madison carried her momentum from the IUPUI kind of shot into this game, played really well. She was 5-8 from the three-point line. Carrie Young, again, had another really quiet 17-type point game and had 6-7 rebounds, 4 assists. Just did a lot of really good things for us, and I really think Carrie can build on the weekend. As much as other people did well, that was an important weekend for Carrie to get some confidence going forward. Macy rebounded really well for us. We defended, I thought, well throughout the game. About half of their shots, the 60 shots they took, about half of them were threes, created a lot of long rebounds for us, and we did turn them into some transition points. So team should feel really good about the weekend. We really bounced back after a tough loss, and I think are playing better basketball now too, which is what you want to be doing this time of year.
With somewhat of a younger squad, the Jacks start 2 sophomores and a freshman. This time of year is a good time of year for the players to see the ball going through the net, and then they gain some confidence as they enter the home stretch of the conference race.
I think confidence is a big part of what we do. I think sometimes players, like it or not, value themselves based on making shots. And we try to emphasize the opposite as coaches. There's so many different things you can do to help a team win. But when you see the ball go in the net as a player, it makes you a better defensive player. It makes you a better rebounder. I think you focus more on what we're trying to do in sets and execution-wise. It just is a really important part of it. So I think the team can build on it, but they need to remember, it's a fragile thing. Making shots is usually a result of what you did beforehand, how you defended, the kind of shots you're getting, how hard you cut, taking care of the ball. So many things go into being a good shooting team. Hopefully we build on all those things, which give us the result we want.
This week, SDSU plays just one game. They'll travel to Tulsa to face Oral Roberts. The Golden Eagles are tied on top of the conference with a 6-1 mark, and they really make things difficult on the defensive side of the ball.
Oral Roberts played an incredibly difficult schedule, non-conference. People don't realize that. They just look at the record and think, maybe they're down. Gosh, they played a tough schedule, and they're very young. So now those young players are playing with far more confidence. They start a couple of sophomores, a couple of freshmen, it seems like, and man, they just are such a good team right now. They're really long inside, so they make it difficult for you to score around the basket. Really quick and explosive on the perimeter, and they're making shots this year. I think they struggled a little bit with that last year, but they're making more perimeter shots. So that's a tough place to play against a very, very good team, and no reason or no surprise to look at where they're at right now and see them right there at the top. So it's going to be a big game for both teams.